Boys, hi. What's up?
Yeah, what's up?
Any one of you, would you tell me about the rock music of the 1970s in Zimbabwe? 1970s, who can tell me about music of the 70s? Zimbabwe, not Jimi Hendrix.
Rock.
Yes, Zimbabwe and rock. Anyone who knows about rock music, come.
Well, my name is Albert Nyanti. I'm a poet, a writer, a musician. Music is my life. Music is some form of drug. Music carries history. It preserves a lot of our past. It tells us who we were, who we are, who we shall be. In the 1960s and 70s, there were musicians like Jimi Hendrix. What's this group from Liverpool? The Rolling Stones, Elvis Presley. However, I did not know that in Zimbabwe you also had rock music. This is Barberfield Stadium, and this is where a lot of music used to happen then. I want to know about music of the 70s. Of course, you're a young man that time, may have been a boy, but I think you know something.
Some of the groups I know, it was Eye of Liberty. Dr. Foot Street. Then after that, we've got that Bulawayo group.
What did they sing? All right, just remind me. Just sing a bit the song sang.
The big storm is coming. We had opened thy crown.
I will tell you the group you have forgotten. Wells Fargo.
Wells Fargo, yeah, that's it. Big storm is coming. The thunder and lightning. You better hold on. Watch out. Big storm is coming. The thunder and lightning. You better hold on.
I started playing music early 70s. Out of just passion, 71, 72, just learning the stuff after school.
Fred Sin is my name. Rock music is my game. If you feel the same, join me in this game without a shame, without a blame. We looked at the positive messages in the music, social commentary, and we decided this is the path for us to go. There were some freedom songs, and we were under oppression at the time, and we thought this is the way to go. Let's use some of these songs to preach to the people.
Some of the stuff that we sang was a bit sensitive, and we were running in with the special branch at the time to come and ask a few questions. What does this song mean?
When we wrote our own songs, we would write songs that were politically motivated, where we would go into different townships, which are the places we lived in at the time, and we would become like heroes because we were musicians. And the people would come around, thousands of people would come together. Sometimes we would actually instigate people to throw stones at the police, and then the riot police would come, and there was a particular incident where I almost got shot when I was hiding in a guava tree. And a bullet missed me by just a few inches.
Music brought everybody together. It broke apartheid. It was really music, peace, you know. After Woodstock, it was all peace, love, God knows what. What else can you ask for?